Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar. Gotta wonder, right? What are we doing back here? Back in the old villa? The cellar? One level? we forgot to go down here. Let's see what's in there. Not sure if we can get back. Hopefully we can. Just make sure not to save over any good save when we're in here. Let's go take a look, see what's in here. Now, supposedly, this is... These are spell scrolls. Did we get rid of these? Parchment. No, it's not. Yeah, I think we might have gotten rid of these. But anyways, talking about... He made a world? A whole new world or something like that? A whole new world? But let's just see what's in here. I don't know if this is it, but... A radiant blue light surrounds you and draws you to its center. Lost Island. Suddenly the bright light around you disappears and you feel a fresh sea breeze on your face. As you look around, you realize you are on an island. One step to the south of you, you see the bleached white bones of a skeleton. There's a house there as well. You find the remains of an orc here. Okay. Chainmail, round shield, horn helmet, leather shoes, an axe, and a torch. And gold. Lost Hut. When you enter this room, you immediately see the chaos surrounding you. All the furniture has been thrown about, holes have been smashed into the walls, and all the doors, apart from the one to the southwest, are standing wide open. It looks as if someone has been searching for something. Did they find it? Will we find it? Looks suspicious, like a dead end or something, right? No. Just making sure they're not like crystal balls or something. In this chest, you find several scrolls and potions, a pile of gold, and, hidden below all this, a piece of the Amberstar. Hell yeah! Okay, so the potions... sleep spell, calm, panic, Amberstar. Is it me who holds the Amberstar? Who's got that thing? Silk does. Well, if we can get back... Are we, like, I think we're out of potions, aren't we? No, we've got... I can hold them. Is it Droba? Is he... Let Droba hold them, actually. He's full? I guess so. Sleep spell, which one is this? Calm, panic? It was like sateen for both of them, actually, but... Okay. So the study, I guess. This door's not open. Ah, this is the one that... You find no traps. Wait, it's silk? Okay. Oh, wait. The lock cannot be opened. Cannot be opened. Villa key? No. Who else has stuff? He's out of lockpicks, that's a thing. That's a lot of potions. Yeah, he literally ran out of slots. Okay, so we got new potions. I guess this is a... might be an upgraded version of this one? So we've got one key here, villa key. So we're not getting in here. We need a knock spell. Okay. Nothing else? Secrets. Reveal your secrets. Can't get past the table for that. Check that one. Alright. I think it's as I feared. I'm looking at ourselves. I wanted to look at the tree. Yeah. Yeah, we're not getting off of here. We need a gate spell. A gate back to our hometown. Well, it's been fun. We'll definitely have to come back here because there's a piece of the Amberstar here. And as far as I know, we need all the pieces of the Amberstar and not just all minus one. So we'll be back to the Lost Island at some point when we find a key for that door, or maybe a lockpick will do. I'm not sure. So also, what we have to do this episode is we have to level up Amethyst, so I'll see you guys there for doing that. Okay, I had to walk back here. I just realized the horse is at Crystal, because we went through tunnels and then came out in Twin Link. So our horse is by the other town. Level training costs 400 gold. That's quite easy for us. Is this giving... Oh, wait a second. No. Which skills should be trained? Okay. Now, I forgot what I said I was going to increase, but what I'm going to increase now is... I wish I had more points. Read magic scroll 25, use magic 23. Hopefully it helps. That's all I can say. Okay, level 4. We need another 333 experience, so let's go step back. And that's it. Oh. I hate when that happens. I'm not going to bother to try to read any more scrolls yet. Maybe with the next level, I will try to read scrolls again. I think I have a few. I'm not sure if they're my level, though. Healing 3, healing 2. I'm thinking not. But we'll certainly attempt next time. Alright, so I'll see you guys back in Crystal. Okay, yeah, so I was mistaken. It wasn't by Crystal, the horse. It's over by the villa. So that's where I left the horse. We traveled not from Crystal through to Twin Lake. Could you imagine the length of that? I mean, it's pretty lengthy as it is, but we traveled from the villa into Twin Lake, so I ran all the way back to Crystal, found the horse not here, and was like, well, and then I remembered. So I'm really just doing this so that Amethyst gets all her spell points and such. Because I don't know how tough a battle this is going to be. So, all that stuff back. And everyone else is at full. Alright, Lord Drebin. Lord Drebin Redux now. How the hell do I get out of here again? This way. Wait, is it this top? New. Because I haven't been here in a while, I forgot. How the hell to get at this? Hold up. Was it right through here? Let's see. No. Oh wait, out here. Am I right? I'm right. Okay. North. Where's Drebin again? This was like episode 12, if I remember right. I was actually looking at it, because I was translating that message. So I'd have it ready when we were there. When we get back there. That's a cool thing I can point to things to. Lord Drebin is... here. Real? No. Here. Alright, we're not far at all. That was the exit. I mean, the entrance I was pointing to. Yeah. Is it? Yes. Because now we have the signet ring, so we should be able to get places we haven't gotten before. I'm going to look at everything over again because it's been quite a while since I've seen all this. The portraits show the ancestors of the Lord Chancellor. This picture shows a man with a long white beard and a proud look. The name is shown below the picture. Calwell Drebin. Huh? This picture shows a beautiful woman with blue eyes. Below the picture is the name Leonore Drebin. Now there's other things to look at around here too. This picture shows a man with red hair and an eye patch. Below the picture is the name Maldor Drebin. Eye patch, huh? This picture shows a woman with a sad expression on her face. Below the picture is the name Fenora Drebin. Okay. I probably already looked at these, but just in case. Alright. Stupid plants. Not a dead end. Alright, so we got this. I remember trying to look at the books and nothing happened. This is a chest? Guess not. But that picture. I can't see it on the other side of the wall. Okay, we go further down, but let me just look at this. This is a nothing. This is a room. This is quite a big area. There's a person here. Alright, we talked. This is a woman? As you speak to the woman, she looks towards you, and you see her face is red with tears. She sobs, "If you're looking for my husband, the Lord Chancellor, then I must disappoint you. A few weeks ago, one of his experiments in the cellar must have gone wrong. He went into the cellar, and then, shortly afterwards, I heard a loud explosion and some horrible laughter. From the day I last saw my husband, I've been trying to reach the cellar, but the door can only be opened with the seal of his signet ring. My husband once had two of these seals, but lost one of them several years ago and couldn't find it again. Well, we found it. Perhaps you can help me to find my husband? I'm not brave enough to go down into the cellar anymore, now that I hear this inhuman moaning and wailing. Perhaps you had first better take a look around his study in the tower. The staircase to the tower is located in our bedroom on the north side of the house. I am too frightened to look there since he has been holding that strange creature prisoner in the glass globe." So we're going to take a look at him again as well. Alright, north side of the house. Alright, what about... Okay, we can't look at that picture. We can't look at that picture. And this is where we were. This is nothing we can... No chest. We need to get some lockpicks for silk. And, I don't know whether it was on or off screen, but I found out that his guild is not, at least at this time, selling them. So we'll have to see what we can see at some point. Alright, so we go out here, here. So we go upstairs before we go into any cellar. I think this is the way to the cellar. Just want to verify. Oh, this is the kid, right? Before you stands a small boy with a terrified look on his face. With a tremble in his voice, he asks, "Have you come to search for my father? I am so frightened for him. For weeks I've been hearing this horrible howling and wailing in the cellar every night. I'm afraid that one night the ghost will come out of the cellar to get me." See what we can do. I think this is the way. That's the cellar. Okay. I was correct in that. So, because, yeah, we have. The signet ring. We should probably have the thief use that, right? Put him on for searching and stuff. So I believe that's the way upstairs. Nothing else to see around here, I think. Yeah. She's in here. Yeah. Hopping from chair to chair. Let's see if there's anything here. Nope. We did find some scrolls and such, but I think I've gotten rid of them. P piece of paper. This must be him. Hurrah! I have today succeeded in transferring the life force of a minor demon into my homunculus. The beast tried to bite me, and for that reason I locked him in the glass cage. I will show him who is in charge here. I finished the cage in the cellar today. Now everything is ready, and tonight I will try to call up a powerful demon. The only thing which bothers me at the moment is that Damon, as I call the homunculus, has still not accepted me as his master. But it doesn't really matter. In the pentagram, no demon can harm me, and the cage in the cellar is strong enough to stop even Bralker, the Prince of Hell. That must be pretty strong indeed. Alright, so Trasric's holding that. 16. Yeah, that's it. Didn't I have some, like, scrolls? Like, parchment or something? Lavitation. Unless they just look like spell scrolls. Parchment? I don't know if this has anything to do with anything. Oh no, that's what we found in, what do you call it? Orlando's wine storage. How about this parchment? The Tower of the Real Master? No, that's something else. I think this is it. Okay. Does this look like a discarded piece of paper? No. Now, can we not open these, or are these, is this nothing? I can't even, can I even look at this while I'm sleeping? No. Okay. Okay. There's that thing. So I'm gonna look at it in a second. This is he imprisoned him in this cage like I just said. A small figure is imprisoned in this globe. It stares at you with large, red, gleaming eyes. Through the thick glass, you hear it speaking strange words to you in a deep voice. It looks very happy, doesn't it? So, this says, "Mortals, look deep into my eyes and see the pain my prince is preparing for you. No one can stop the plans of Prince Bralker. He will suck your soul from your body the way you suck an egg." Excuse me, but I don't suck eggs, so that does not apply. I'm just making sure if there's anything here to look at. All right. Where does that go? If I should review what we went through, or if I should. In fact, I just off-screen went in there, and I wasn't sure if I was going to get back, so that's why this is already lit up. This just goes here. So, I guess the signet ring is further past here. Right. We made it this far. The item opens the door. Do you want to attack or flee? What are we fighting? Oh, we got slimes or something. Okay. a teen would just hang out then. Alright. I'll hang out as well. Ectoplasma. Hit for 8. Ow! 17! Droba! He's got a lot of hit points, though. He'll be okay. 1 and 9, better. So this is different, that we're not... We're not going around first-person tunnels, we're walking around here fighting things, which I didn't think would happen, but... It's happening, so I got ectoplasma. Oh. Joe and you are getting bashed around, but he can take a beating. He can take a beating, but he has heart trouble getting, giving a beating. Everybody's getting a hit, minor. I like to focus on one, but we'll end up spending a lot of rounds just moving over people. So I don't know if I'm even going to notice a difference casting spells. Nice! Okay. So now we'll move him over. So this one's gonna be pretty injured already. Now we were all attacking that one, right? Oh no, he's not attacking anymore. Oh, that's right, they were attacking that one. I wish we were able to get off that island. There was a lot of neat stuff there. A lot of potions. Ouch. Okay, we're gonna need to heal Griban up a little bit. It should be almost dead. So we're not hitting it for a lot. Nice. Still ticking. Nice. 16 experience. This thing has rations somehow. No money. money, just rations. Alright. Should I try to heal him? Healing one. Ribbon. Fails. What is he at anyway? 55 out of 118. Nice. Alright, so I got 4 points. I will do my best. Oh, no! I didn't... Are you kidding me? He's unharmed. Oh my god. But on the plus side, it did work twice. Can't wait till I get my... But... No. Can't wait till I get my, what do you call it? My spell's up really good. 59? 64, okay. It's going to be a serious quality of life improvement once I can cast these spells without them failing, fizzling, just basically turn into a piece of crap. Such is the way of the wizard. Start off, you're weak as hell. Total fail all the time. And then, wow. Are you kidding me? Am I just stuck and fail? Should I just not even try anymore? Am I like exhausted from casting the spell over? Oh, so there's another thing there, right? I see it. Yet it's not attacking me. Do I have to run into the monster? Maybe they just go so slow. You gotta be kidding me. I guess I'm like tired out now. Oh, I want to attack.